Hello everyone, today we are going to solve the second question of kinematics from IE Rudolph in the series. So the question is like a point traversed half the distance with velocity v naught and the remaining half part of the distance with velocity v1 for half the time and with velocity v2 for other half of the time. Let's formulate the problem. Say the total distance traversed is s and s, and this half distance is traversed with v naught, so velocity is v naught. Let's say time is t dash, say, and they say the remaining half part of the distance with velocity v1 for half the time. Say this distance is velocity, say this distance is s1 and this distance is s2, where s1 plus s2 is again equals to s with velocity v1 and time is t, and here we have velocity v2 and time is t. We cannot say these two parts are equal, s1 and s2 are equal, but I can say s1 plus s2 is equals to s. So just keep a simple thing in mind that they are asking about mean velocity, and mean velocity is always total displacement upon total time. So total displacement, what is the total displacement? That is s plus s1 plus s2 divided by total time is t dash plus t and t. Here we have 2t, and it can be written like this: 2s upon 2t plus t dash. Okay, now what is t dash? We have to convert t in terms of s. So what is t dash? T dash is s upon v naught. Very simple. Now we have to convert these t and this t in terms of s. So let's say s1 is equals to, because the motion is uniform, so s1 is equals to v1 into t, and s2 is equals to v2 into t. Adding both, we have to add both. S1 plus S2 is equals to V1 plus V2 into T, and S1 plus S2 is again equals to S upon V1 plus V2, that is equals to T. Now put these terms, this T dash and this T, in this equation. So mean velocity will become 2S upon 2 times T, that is 2S upon V1 plus V2 plus what is t dash? T dash is s upon v naught. Now we can cancel s and s, so we are left with this 2 upon 2 v1 plus v2 plus 1 upon v naught, and we have to solve this. When we will solve this, we will get this v naught and v1 plus v2 as LCM, and here we will get 2 v naught plus v1 plus v2. So the mean velocity that will be equals to, if we will solve this, this will be like this: 2 v naught v1 plus v2 by reciprocal, and 2 v naught plus v1 plus v2, and that's my answer. Thank you.